Reserve time.
Going for this kill. He's got another void in 5 seconds time if he just chases S4 down. Oh, what a sleep from Puppy. Girl comes in to tether up S4. They'll try to turn this one around. Catching Gimba in some trouble. Now needs to head for the hills. Could this be her first blood going the other way? One more auto attack. They'll get it. It's Curl on the Wisp that finds the bonus gold in the last hit. Now toward the top lane. It's Arteezy that's in some trouble. Kinetic Field comes out, throws a dagger. And
he's praying to the Iron Jesus right now. He has got 7 sick charges, so okay. They don't actually come that close to killing him off. He's just trying to bait him in even a little further.
And a stick here on Zai. Mushi rotating over. Kinetic Field will actually put Zai on the other side, trapping Puppy in. Nightmare out onto Mushi. Zai will set up for the Berserker's Call. There's your ulti from the Zeus trying to get Mushi into dunk range, and they find him. He gets decapitated. First kill of this skirmish, but now Zai will get turned around on as the tombstone comes. More rotations as now Ketchik Imba joining the party, bumps into Puppy, kisses him in the trees, throws out a silence, darkness is online, and Puppy in big trouble. The Bane Elemental will fall. It's a 1-for-2 with Team Malaysia getting the better of it.
Yeah.
And he's getting into this stage where he's not really snowballing, and all that thought is Mushi up top gets jumped on by Arteezy. Still Static Storm Kinetic Field comes out, sets it up for his teammates to come in and maybe turn something around. Puppy jumped on it, Zai comes in, Berserker's Call on 2, ultimate from Zeus doing huge damage. A Mecha's Pop keeps catching Imba alive a little bit longer, but the Fiend's Grip gets another full duration channel. Now Secret on the run, Kuro and S4 both very low, Ohio low on mana. Can he actually bring him down? He can! It's the double kill for the Undying is now KYXY. Long range zip forward, wants to bring down Zai, has quite a bit of mana left to play around with, and of course has the Aegis of the Immortal, so can afford to be rather aggressive here if need be. Ohio even joining the party. Zai, I think, destined to head to the grave with this one.
You're running out of mana on your Bristleback, but doesn't look like it's going to matter. Storm gets the kill, and you talk about that Bloodstone. Now 900 gold, he just needs to pick up the energy booster and the recipe.
About 50% damage. Mushi TP's back, and there's KYXY, jumps in deep, goes on to Kuro, gets crit by Arteezy. Glimpse back, that'll break the tether. Can Malaysia actually punish this and find the kills that they're looking for? Kuro getting low, but now Arteezy comes in, gets some crits on Johnny, cuts him to pieces. And the Flesh Golem just left as a corpse on the ground. 10-second BKB used by Arteezy as Mushi plays Ring Around the Rosie. Kuro gets brought down by the SNY Bristle, and now Artur will BKB TP out. Ends up being support for support trade, but it's not done yet. Ketchik Imba, he's duking it out with Puppy and Zai. It's a 2-on-1, just trying to buy some time for his teammates to get here and punish this. Puppy, the one that gets left behind, throws out a Nightmare, and he will... And his team does secure that room.
And that's your Night Stalker, Aghanim Scepter now, so vision control.
Both on and off the panel, and an item that naturally synergizes pretty well with him also. Team Fight gonna break out in the top lane, the long range zip. They want to focus down Kuro. Ketchik Imba, he's the one caught inside of the Fiend's Grip. Kuro stays alive, and they'll lose their Night Stalker to get things started. Puppy will get punished in return. Tombstone focused by Arteezy. Zai getting low. Berserker's Call comes out. Force Snap to the low ground. Lives on 30 HP. Aegis of the Immortal gets deployed, and Kuro, one more auto attack will bring him down. They finish him off. Arteezy still alive, reasonably healthy, but Electric Vortex is there. Now Zai from the low ground reinitiates onto KYXY. Him and Ohio, the only two left alive, but he's zipping around like a madman. He's still alive for now. Arteezy may go down, but no, it's the Bristle that falls to S4. The ultimate's there, that'll finish off the storm. Somehow, someway, Secret win the fight.
Zeus staying alive that long in a team fight. Oh, that is brutal. S4's damage output there with just bolt after bolt. The static field damage as well. That was just huge for Team Secret. Not to mention Arteezy still alive at the end of things as well. He is suddenly looking very scary on this PA.
Tools for this next team fight. There's no more Aegis of the Immortal. It was used in that last one. Nightmare onto Ohio. Ultimate from Zeus to help soften him up. Disruptor, the first one to go down, but still gets off his ultimate. Not too bad of a start for Malaysia, but Arteezy just going mad all over this Dire team. Crits left and right. They've already lost two, and everyone else on low HP. Now they get the Bristle back. KYXY put inside of the Nightmare, setting up for the Berserker's Call. They've got it. And they've got the kill. 4-0. Johnny nowhere to go. It's going to be a full 5-man wipe. Secret erupting with momentum, and now we'll finally see a big lead.
That was big. That was just... really, really bad for Team Malaysia. This PA just getting more and more farm, just getting kill after kill. The Wisp doing what he needs to keep the PA alive and dishing out good damage. And S4 doing what we saw last game from KYXY. He's got 18 Bloodstone charges already on his Zeus. Oh, they've caught one.
They'll find Puppy. Static Storm Kinetic Field comes out, and this should be a pretty easy kill, but no, Arteezy comes in. Bristleback will finish off Puppy. Now goes in on the Kuro. There is a relocate here. So Curl could try to do this defensively, but no, try to TP out. Storm zips across, brings him down. Arteezy with a BKB on, will fight as long as he can. Glimpse brings back one. Buyback from Curl. Will ultimate into the fight, tethers up onto Arteezy, but it'll cost him his life. It's a dieback now for the Wisp, and a triple kill for Ohio. Arteezy does isolate the Undying with the help of Zai. They'll sandwich him there as Ohio reinitiates. Do they want Zai or do they want Arteezy? Maybe even both. Can they get the 2-for-1 special? Ohio getting low. In comes the Storm Spirit. Down goes the axe. Arteezy low and in the grave. Double kill for KYXY and Team Malaysia. Take the fight.
Really nice buyback from Storm.
Rekko down. Looks like Arteezy will go in and just start poking barracks.
Range Rex, yeah. No heal available to this, and you either glyph or you just lose your range Rex. And
looks like it will be the latter. Ohio gets caught by the Fiend's Grip, but the refresher from S4, the double ulti bringing Malaysia low. Pipe from Johnny comes out a little bit late. Now the rest of the fight will break out. It's only a 1-for-0 trade. Curl rather low on the backside as Arteezy is just doing an absurd amount of damage. Blinks forward, finishes off the disruptor. Nightstalker gets decapitated by Zai. He'll buy back. But there's still two in the grave as the Storm Spirit was also picked. This top lane of barracks will fall, at least the range will. There is a glyph, but they'll use it.
With a melee Rex down, this puts Malaysia in a really tough bind. Haven't lost it just yet, but doesn't seem like something they can position themselves to defend in.
Storm's buyback still on cooldown from the last fight. Low on Bloodstone charges. They will find the Bane. A gem hits the deck. Zai blinks in with the Berserker's Call. Ohio getting very aggressive, pushes outside of the base. Will try to chase down Zai. He eats the cheese. Ohio still not scared. He'll get disarmed, cuff him into the halberd, and that'll force him to back off. Meanwhile, on the base, Arteezy.
Well,
die back on the Night Stalker. Undying also headed back to the grave, and Malaysia in big trouble. This could end up being the GG push right here, Parker. Secret getting so much out of this. Mushi, the only survivor for now. Now a buyback from the Bristle. Storm responds also. Arteezy uses the BKB, still has the Aegis. Rains the stun from the skies. They break down the Storm Spirit. Arteezy still alive as Ohio forced ahead into the well. Oh,
the Bloodstone Suicide heals everyone back up. Kuro and Arteezy, they're going to keep on pushing.
What a play from
S4. And Zeus is back alive. Boots of Travel. He had 20 plus Bloodstone charges.
What a heads up
play. This push isn't stopping.
With the tether onto Arteezy, that takes him to full HP. They go straight for the tier 4 towers. Looks like they'll take game 2 in style with just one lane of barracks down. And that's it. GG from Mushi. They've had enough. That'll take us to a game 3.
Well, a flashy way to end things. And Team Secret bounce back after a surprising game 1. They force a decider.
My oh my. A bit unexpected, I think. At least from where that game started out. It seemed like Team Malaysia had a little more momentum. Johnny had a pretty good opener. Ohio with an incredible score at the end of that game, 14-3-10. Felt like the Disruptor was the weak link for that team almost. Just didn't offer too much, didn't really seem to do much in the way of countering the Wisp, which I would imagine was the intention to pick him up so early.
The relocate ganks were never a problem. The Wisp is almost picked entirely just for the tether with the heal.